Today we're going to talk about the difference between AC charging and DC charging. DC charging is often referred to as fast charging or supercharging, and I will try to explain the difference. When you talk about AC, it's abbreviation for alternating current, and that means that it has like waves on the water that comes from the grid, and this is the energy we want to use. When we talk about DC, it's more like a river. You have a steady stream of water going in only one direction. The river needs to flow into the tank, so to speak. Since the grid is always AC, we have to convert it to DC to be able to charge the battery. When we talk about DC charging in cars or boats, it means that we transfer from AC to DC on shore or outside the boat, outside the car. This enables us to use a much larger charger, a more expensive charger, since it's not inside the boat and it's a shared asset between many boats or cars. So then we can have a very high power charger on shore, and then we can charge the batteries much faster. Evoy 1, the boat we have here, is capable of taking very high power charging. The batteries are capable of taking 300 kilowatts of charging power, and that gives a very fast charging time, so you can fill the batteries from 20 to 80% less than half an hour. So the contacts here are both for AC and DC. You have AC on the top and DC on the bottom. So you have a common charging plug, which is called a combined charging system. This is very much used in Europe. What will it mean that we are able to charge faster? It means that we can travel longer routes when we can stop and charge on the way. It's acceptable if they can make a short grab of piece of food or go to the toilet and things like that, rather than waiting for 10 hours. So then the boats will be more accepted by the larger boating community, that it can be used for everyday use and also for longer trips.